Hey, welcome back, class. And let's take a look at the next plate. And the next plate is this plate here. And so let's start off by readjusting our planes. So grabbing those corners. Hope that's enough. All right, perfect. Start off with the front plane, sketch. I'm gonna call this the double O's. A double O's, just because I see two openings, they look like zeros, and we just call them double O's. The front plane is the sketch plane. And so let's begin by drawing this out. So I think what I'll do is, this is an interesting question here. So this origin, why not? I'm just gonna place a couple of construction lines on there. LQ, go from here all the way across. And then, you know, I'm going to do it. I'm going to take, I think I'm going to take this particular O, this hole, and I'm going to place it here. So I'll take the one on the right side. Go here. Give it a diameter of 20. And then take another circle and give it a diameter of 35. All right. And so I will do the same. Let me construct this circle here, though, or this construction line. And also another one over here. And strain it. Draw another circle. Those constraints, I don't need them. Get rid of them. What I want to do is I want to just set them equal to the defined constraints on the right side. It makes it much easier. So yeah, whenever you have a constraint and you can use the equality constraint, utilize it. Good. Now let's use this circle here, the radius of 50. Snap that into place using the tangent tool. And let's use the cut tool called the trim tool. There it is. Nice. Hey, welcome back, class. So now let's figure out how to add the bottom portion of this diagram against a 3D model. And so I need to find a center point. So what I'm going to do is create a point on the construction line here. Then I'm going to constrain it. Well, see if I can choose a midpoint. If I just hover here, does it activate? Is that? So it doesn't, so I'll have to just measure it out. So what I'll do is it says 50, and so I'm gonna go 25. So from here to here, make that 25. That's the midpoint, and now I'm going to utilize that midpoint and draw a construction line. Okay, so here. We got about here. Should be enough. Okay, it's okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure from this center line down to this midpoint, this point on the midpoint construction line. Make that 87. And from here, draw another point and give this distance 45. So now I have some dimensions to utilize, draw my shapes. So there's a kind of a rectangular shape, and it's a width of 20. So I'm going to draw that out using the center point rectangle. And nope, I didn't like that at all. Let's try that again. There we go. I think it's 20. And looks like by 30 looks okay, I guess. Okay, there you go. 20 by 30. And notice that the bottom portion of this rectangle is attached to that midpoint, which is 45 units from this lower point. And I utilize that technique again. So let's go up here. This is going to be 10. So we'll make this 10 by 47. Perfect. I've got that shape. And again, I utilized that center point rectangle and used the some constraints to make sure that those rectangles form that inner portion of this diagram. So now let's take a circle tool, draw a diameter of 50. Constrain it. And another circle. And utilize the dimension tool. Actually, the equal tool. Constrain it with the equal sign. Got it. Now let's use the tangent tool. So it's that one. Perfect. So there's the general shape there. We use some cut tools. Cut some of the stuff out, see what it looks like, okay? If you wanted to leave it like that, you probably could and extrude it. If you wanted to see the original construction, it's perfectly acceptable. And I'm going to clean it up just a bit. Let's trim this up here. And I think I'll leave it as such. It's going to be okay if I do that. Okay. So let's extrude by 20. Double O is extrude, and we have it. Okay. Now there's this edge here from the previous rectangle. See that? And if you don't like that, we can, you know, remove it. I could cut this out if I if it was necessary. I could. Let's see. I think it's going to be all right. Let's see. If I start cutting, I wonder if I'm going to lose some of this these constraints. That's okay. We'll leave it. I'm going to leave it. I mean, you know, I could constrain it or cut. Hmm. So you can see there that the circles became unconstrained and again, could be a coinciding tool maybe. It seems to be. So you can see that tilted a bit, see that? And I'll constrain it using the horizontal to watch this. Oh, did not like that. So we got some issues there. Let's constrain this with the horizontal tool right now. There we go. And now let's move these points here. Not sure if that's gonna work. Let's see. Nope. Leave it. Just gonna leave it like that. And so this tool here, see how it's moving like that? Shouldn't be doing that. No, sorry. So that's moving. And it shouldn't be. So we're just going to keep our original constraints there. Not fret. Okay. Leave it as is for now. And again, you know, the technique I'm using is not perfect, but we'll go with it. So here we are. There's my shape. Okay, I love it. Now let's extrude this portion here on the side. This portion right here, let's extrude that. And so I'm gonna draw a sketch. And I'm gonna choose this plane here. Okay. There we go. And I'm gonna draw a rectangle. That's 10 by, according to the directions, it's 5 units off the edge there, so it would be 5, it would be 10, it would be 10 by 35. Okay, there it is. 10 by 35. Perfect. And so what I'll do is draw a rectangle from the corner now. So let's get a corner rectangle. Go here. We're going to type 10 by 35. So now let's constrain this rectangle from this corner here to this corner. It's got to be 10 units. As in the diagram. And, oh no, 5 units. There we go. So now let's extrude that a total of how many units? Question, how many units? Looks like we're going to extrude it. So the thickness here is 10, so extrude it by 10. We're going to remove. And there you have it. And we'll call this remove rectangle. Or rectangle remove. Call this here rectangle. Accept it. And there you have it. Well, it looks pretty darn good. So there's a little inconsistency here. I'm gonna leave it right in here. And it may be correct, 100%, not 100% sure if it is or isn't. But I will leave it. And there you go. Don't forget to add your drawing, your technical. drawing. You can have all this information, okay, in your technical drawing. All right, like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. See you soon. Bye-bye.